Hi, my name is Angel Nelson, and I'm a research associate here at the Allen Institute for Cell Science. And today, I'm going to demonstrate how to set up the WTC parental line and one of our gene-edited cell lines for cardiac differentiation. Let's get started. So we'll be starting with the cells already in a single cell suspension. Go ahead and click on the link that just popped up on your screen if you'd like to view the video that details that step. I've already counted the cells and they're at a known concentration. I've also already plated the cells in 10 centimeter plates for undifferentiated growth to maintain the cell line. This differentiation protocol has been optimized for the WTC cell line and has also been tested across many of the edited lines in the Allen cell collection. We are using a small molecule protocol and we're going to be plating the cells for differentiation in a six-well format. Let's get started. First, I'm using media that I've already made up, so we'll be plating the cells in M-teaser plus rock. I'll go ahead and remove the Matrigel from this pre-coated plate. And I'm going to preload the wells with media. I like to do that step where I add 1 mL to each of the wells first and then go back and fill them with a remaining 2 mL. Okay, so now I have my two cell lines, the WTC parental line and my gene edited line. And assuming that potentially I've had some settling in my cells, I'm going to gently resuspend them again. So we'll start with one cell line at a time. And we're just gonna gently resuspend the full length of the volume of media. Now I'm plating the cells in three different densities, 175, 225, and 250 thousand cells per well. And so I've already made those calculations based on the concentration of my cells. I'm gonna add the cells to the well in a dropwise motion. And I am working quickly here because the cells will start to attach and I wanna make sure that they are nicely spread around the well before they do so. Okay, so that was my first cell line. Now I'm going to gently rock this plate to try to distribute the cells that I have put in those wells. Okay, now I'm ready to plate my second cell line. I'm going to gently resuspend. And again, I'm adding the cells quickly and in a circular dropwise motion to try to get them dispersed around the well evenly. I'm also plating the second line at those same three densities. Let's distribute the cells again here in the hood. Now we're ready to put the cells in the incubator. So it's really important that the cells are evenly distributed around the well. So when you place them in the incubator, it's important to give the plate a little bit of a shake. So I'm gonna gently go forward and back, wait for the wave to stop, and then side to side. And you can do that two or three times to ensure, again, that those cells are evenly distributed all around the well. Okay. So we just put the cells in the incubator. We're going to leave them undisturbed and check them tomorrow. So yesterday we plated the cells for differentiation, and in our protocol that's denoted as day minus three. Let's get them out of the incubator and look at their morphology. So these look good. What I'm looking for is a nice even distribution of the cells around the well and not very much cell death. I'm gonna take these back to the hood where we're gonna change the media to M-teaser only, not containing any rock. I'm gonna change the media one cell line at a time. So I'll aspirate off from this first row here. Gentle with the cells at this point to not disrupt them in the well. So I'm going to gently place the tip of my pipette up against the wall of the well and gently distribute the media into the well. And again, I like this technique of adding a mil to all of the wells first and then going back and adding in the rest of the media. Now for the second cell line. Again, really nice and slow. Tomorrow is denoted as day minus one in the protocol, where we do exactly the same thing as today. Let's meet back here in 2 days where we actually activate the cells for cardiac differentiation. So today's day zero, and that's when we actually activate the cells for differentiation. Let's quickly look at them under the microscope first to look at confluency and their morphology. Okay, so today what I'm looking for is a really nice undifferentiated stem cell-like morphology. If the cells are not healthy and undifferentiated going into the differentiation, it's likely that it won't work. Also, I'm looking for the different confluencies as I did plate out different densities of cells on day minus three. So we activate our cells for cardiac differentiation using a 7.5 micromolar chiron in RPMI B27 without insulin media that has been pre-warmed in a 37 degree water bath. And just like the other media changes from before, we're going to do one cell at a time, and we're going to be very careful not to disturb the cells. and I'm gonna just gently have the tip of my pipette resting on the wall of the well. And I'm dispensing the media really slowly. Okay, moving on to the next cell line. Okay, now I'm gonna set a timer because the next step is very time sensitive. And for now, these cells can go in the incubator and we'll leave them undisturbed for the next 48 hours. So it's day two now and exactly 48 hours have passed. So we're going to change the media to a 7.5 micromolar IWP2 in RPMI B27 without insulin media. This also has been warmed in a 37 degree water bath. It's important right now that I move efficiently and don't have the cells out of the incubator too long as they are fragile at this point. Okay, and just like all the media changes before, we're gonna do one cell line at a time, and we're going to move gently so that the cells are not disturbed. Go ahead and stop my timer, which reads exactly 48 hours. The cells can go back in the incubator and remain undisturbed for another 48 hours until we reach day four. So the remaining steps of the protocol are media changes. On day four, you'll change the media to RPMI B27 without insulin. On day six, it's RPMI B27 with insulin. You'll want to monitor your cells daily, and every other day, change the media with the RPMI B27 with insulin. If the experiment was successful, you can expect to see beating cardiomyocytes at day seven. And our complete protocol is on our website, allencell.org/methods. Thanks so much for watching, and good luck with your experiments.